Oh god, I don't know where the microphone is. Okay. It is 7 o'clock in the morning. I'm going to go get my car because it is the morning of New York. It's gonna be cold and I'm scared. I'm gonna get frozen. It's my first time on a plane and I'm going to shart my pants.
Before our journey began, we had to go have breakfast. So, you know, only the best for my family.
Waffle House is amazing and no one can take that away from me.
So at the beginning of the flight, this is kind of what, every time I looked out the window, this is what it looked like. It was just the never-ending white void. So I just kind of closed the window, and I just expected that to be the only thing you could see the entire flight. But then after a little bit, as you can see here, our flight was horrible. This first flight I had was kind of garbage, you know. There were two seats on each side, you know, of the aisle. Usually it's three. I'm like, what the heck? There was also no TV. I was like, what? Why? Why don't they have TVs on the planes? I thought they had flights on TVs. The ceiling of the plane was like an inch above me. If I was to get on my tippy toes, I would scrape my head the whole way, like walking on it. And it looked more like, I felt like it was more like a jet than a plane, but it's just, I guess it's whatever. So you see those people standing to the side? Yeah, that's like a line to pick up all our like luggage. And we didn't know that, so we just kind of walked by and didn't get any of our stuff. Because we had to transfer flights. Kind of like the little first problem we had. But we were able to resolve it real fast. We just asked someone, and they're like, oh, okay, I'll go get it for you because you can't go back in. And I was like, okay, whatever, sure, thank you.
We got lost, but now we know where we're going.
And here at the Washington, D.C. airport, we decided to treat ourselves for surviving our very first flight. Now this is where our first real problem starts. So we're eating, enjoying our smash burger, my mom her salad, and I hear a lady on the intercom say, the flight right here to Charleston is ready to go. And I'm like, we're not going to Charleston. Because, like, we weren't. I'm like, so I was confused. So I went up to go up to the lady and I ask her, hey, am I in the right place? And then she looks at me, I give her my ticket. She looks at it. She types some stuff on the computer. She's like, I think it's the gate over there. Gate 33. I think that's what she said. I think it's gate 33. And I'm like, oh, okay, thanks. So I go to my parents. And I'm like, okay, so we're at the wrong gate. I'm going to go to that one and just check to make sure. And they're like, okay. So they stay and keep eating. And I go over there, which is like just at the other side of like the hallway, the end of the hallway, like big little passageway thing. So I go there, I go up to our gate, and I'm like, and then I see it, New York LGA. I'm like, oh, that must be our flight. Let me go ask the lady just to confirm. because I had asked other people before where our gate was, and they told us the one we were at already, but that one was just wrong. I asked two people, so it was okay. So I go up to them just to make sure, and then I asked them, hey, am I in the right spot? And then they check my tick, and they're like, oh yeah, but we're closing this gate in 3 minutes. And I went like, huh? They're like, yeah, if you're not here in 3 minutes, we're gonna close these doors and we're just not gonna open them back up. I'm like, oh, okay, let me go get my family. So I ran over to my family because we had 3 minutes and counting, less than 3 minutes. I run over to them. I'm like, yo, we're in the wrong bridge. We're in the wrong gate. We need to go now. We have 3 minutes to get there. So we all hurry up. Like, we all park our stuff up. I had finished my burger already, so I'm fine. My mom throws her salad in her backpack. My dad finishes up his burger real fast. My little brother, who was sharing fries with my dad, ended up just throwing them away without giving any to my dad. My dad got kind of sad.
We are 3 minutes away from missing flight. Oh my gosh.
Thank you.
So we ran over there, we got on the flight just in time. There were actually some people also like right behind us, because I guess they were at the wrong spot too, or they were late. So we weren't the last people on, but still, we almost missed our flight. That was pretty scary.
Getting off plane 2, could not record. I hate Nikado avocado.
Went to the baggage claim, got my mom's luggage, and then we got a taxi. Nobody wanted to give us a ride because 4 people, everyone wanted like, hey, I can take 2 or 3 people, but not 4. Then one guy eventually said, ah, yeah, F it, I'll take you 4. We took a taxi, went to our hotel, and that was kind of the end of the first day. Here's the hotel. Alright, day 2, here we go. My parents went out last night and went to get food. We filled up the fridge, little fridge they gave us. We got fruits. I got this really nice, authentic Chinese soup. Yeah, I bet I'm gonna have it later. Mm-hmm. Yep, it'll be a bunch of stuff. As you can see, we already made the room into a mess. It happens, you know, my little brother's looking for good channels, watching Thomas Train right now. And yeah, also I need to show you guys something, hold on. Look, that's the bathroom that's open, and right next to it is the shower. So like everyone on my floor has to share this bathroom and the shower, which is kind of sad. There we go. First time outside in New York, like daytime, I can actually see well and not be scared of getting mugged. Look at it all. It's so pretty. Because it's morning, we decided to go have breakfast. I found a place called the Crepes of Columbus. I love crepes. I usually go to my IHOP, but all the IHOPs nearby closed down. So I'm like, let's go there. Finally arrive, and something that's different in New York, and that doesn't happen in Florida, is if you want to eat in a restaurant or if you want to eat inside anywhere, you have to be vaccinated and you have to show a worker your vaccination card, and then they'll let you sit there and eat. Because a lot of places in New York have security. Here we go, menu. All the food looked very good. A lot of crepes, real nice. Breakfast food, it looked real good. Here's the food I got. It was so unbelievably good, dude. It was pretty small, but it was so good. My dad's food was up top. He loved everything except for the meat, the little steak. But dude, my food was so good, dude. It was a Nutella strawberry crepes. Oh! Here we are, first time in the subway. It looks pretty cool, I guess. It's pretty basic. And then I saw this thing on the wall. We needed to go somewhere, and oh my gosh, I did not know how to use it. But we eventually were able to figure it out, and we got to our destination safely. Woo, first time inside a train, underground, let's go, the subway! And here we are at the Rockefeller Center. It's pretty much the big Christmas tree in New York. So my mom wanted to go, we saw it, and I knew that nearby the Rockefeller Center was a place that I really wanted to visit. Because, I was in New York, and I knew there was this one place I really wanted to go to. And so I checked, and it was really close. It was literally, like, in the area, like, a 10-minute walk. So we walked there, and here it is. You can see the statue. The Golden Mario. That's right. This is the Nintendo New York City store. I was popping off. This was going to be my gamer's paradise. Look at the Golden Mario. He's so beautiful. The line was pretty long to enter. I wasn't going to record us just standing in line and not doing anything. And here we go. It was finally our turn to go in. The lady inside signaled us, come on in, and we walked up. And from the moment I walked in, I lost. Pretend it's November. I lost. Look at everything. Look at the gamer. Look at the games. Look at the plushies. They have Metal Mario plushie, which I've never seen before. They have the good guys and the bad guys from Mario. Look at Babam. Here we have the gamer wall. All the games. Most of the Nintendo games are like the good ones. And here we go. And we decided, let's go upstairs. And we saw Luigi and Toad at the bottom with like the little Mushroom King in the background. And up there you see the main man. The great man himself. Who is it? The one and only. And there's some cringe stuff on the wall. It's Super Mario! Look at that, Super Mario! They had the new Pokemon game came out, so they had a little display for it. They had a bunch of plushies of all the Pokemon. They had a little Splatoon section. They have a like Pikachu in every single costume. He's wearing the skins of his fallen brethren. And here we have a beautiful wall. Every single Nintendo console ever made, from the Game & Watches, the DSs, the Wiis. A bunch of DSs here. They made a lot of DSs. The Game Boys. Oh, the Game & Watch. They had a bunch of stuff. The Virtual Boys. All that. Here, if I go to the other side, you can see. Boom. The Famicom. The Super Nintendo. Oh my god. Boom. There's the Wii up top. The Nintendo Switch. The Lite. The Wii U. The one that no one cares about. The Wii U. The 64. The GameCube. They had Rob. They had freaking Rob from Smash Bros. There. Why is Rob from Smash there? Like, what? It was so great. I loved it. They had little Mario Karts, I guess, considered a console. I don't know. Here I am going over to the amiibo stand. Every single amiibo ever made was right here. Here's all the Mario and Mario parties. You can see the Mario cereal. I actually bought that once. It was pretty good. You can see from here, the Golden Mario. There's Waluigi. Oh, he deserved to be in Smash, not Sora. Here we go. All the Splatoons, all the Link ones. Here we have a bunch of the Smash ones. Pretty much like from here on out, it's Smash. Look at Terry. They got the Terry one here already. I kind of want the Terry. I have the Joker one. There's Sonic in the back. There's DK. Look at DK and Mario, the main boys. There's Pac-Man. Every single Smash character. It's so cool, man. Over here, we have Animal Crossing, Yucky, just move that to the side. We have some of the Kirby ones, those are pretty nice. We have like just the little random ones, you know, Detective Pikachu, two airplanes. Bowser and DK from, gosh, I forgot. Skylanders, we have the Splatoon gun, the ink shooter. They have the Captain Falcon helmet, which is super cool. They have the Fox Blasters. No one cares about Fox. It's irrelevant, you know. The Falcon helmet is really cool. Here we have a Game Boy that was damaged in the Gulf War, and it still works. Nintendo, please, please, you can do this again. It's literally been so long. Like, everything that I buy now from you just breaks after a little bit. Please make your stuff like you made this Game Boy. This Game Boy went through a war, through bombs, through bullets. It's been through so much, and it still works. Tetris is being played on it. It's a relic of the past. And now I buy Joy-Cons for 80 smackaroos, and they get drift after like 2 months. Please, Nintendo, go back to your roots. Oh, and yeah, here's Princess Peach's clothing, her little gloves and her tiara. Oh, okay, so pretty much all I bought at New York was this Super Mario shirt, and they were gonna give me a cringy Zelda bag, and I'm like, actually, can I have the big DK bag? And the worker's like, yeah, sure. So here's the big DK bag, which I have in my room. Also, as we were walking, we saw this. Let's go! then we entered a pretty boring like museum thing. I kind of went boom. It's really close by as well, was the freaking Times Square. Wow. Times Square. This is the thing everyone always talks about, you know, New York Times Square. Woo. It was all right. It was all right. No cap, no easy. It was just like, oh, look, really tall buildings. Wow. And big screens. I love the big screens. The buildings are all right, but the screens, I can play Smash Bros on that. Day 3. Oh, I messed it up. My bad. I started off this morning by watching Ridiculously for like 5 hours. Yesterday we went to Five and Below and I got this really cool phone case. I love it. It's really clear, not disgusting and dirty like the last one I had. Here, I saw a rat run in there. I couldn't get a freaking image of a rat. I'm so sad, but I'll get one eventually. I will. I promise that I didn't get any footage of a rat. For today's destination, we'll be taking the subway again! Woo! We have been teleported to a boat in which we will take a ferry, a little cruise to see the Statue of Liberty. Look at all the pretty buildings. The freaking, like, the view from the boat is so good, dude. I don't know what to tell you. Like, there's a bridge, there's a Brooklyn Bridge, and a bunch of other buildings. And there she is, the Statue of Liberty herself. She is a beauty. I did not go on the island because, I'm stupid and poor, but it's okay. Small price to pay. I'm on the swing, but, as you can hear for it in the psych, I'm suffering a little bit.
My hands are freezing.
Our parents soon told us, hey, let's go. So I got off, and my little brother got off like a dog. He face planted, jumping off. And then we went to the Macy's, the big one. And you know what I did? I sat down, charged my phone, and waited for my parents to finish shopping. And everyone was staring at me. Here's some nice footage. Empire Building. Nice. We went to this kind of Chinese buffet and it was really good. And oh, look, I'm in the back. Here we have Times Square at night. I think it looks better at night in person. My camera is a little special, so everything looks like extra. All the screens look extra lit up. Then we went to the Disney store and only a few seconds of the Disney store because I don't want the mouse to find me and copyright me for, you know, recording in his store. Oh my gosh, is he okay? And then woo, subway back home. Oh, hi, mom. All right, here we go. Day 3. Nope, it's 4. I'm stupid. It's okay. Today we went to grab breakfast at this really nice Mexican restaurant. It was really good food. Oh, look at the pool. We have New York menaces driving on the sidewalk. Classic New Yorkians. I feel like Kung Fu Panda here going up all the steps. And look at the funny cats. Pretty cats over there. Just straight cats just chilling. Funny building. Let's go, subway! I actually took the wrong subway, but we are able to figure it out.
Okay, this is the right one.
We bought some tickets to ride a tour bus to go all around New York, so here's some footage of that. Can I put my balls in your jaw? We then were walking by, just, you know, by the shops, shopping a little more. And then I saw a big sign that called to me. It screamed at me. And I knew I wanted to go there badly. What did the sign say? It said, Dave and Buster's. Oh, another gamer time for me. So we went in, got our card, and then I got scammed in Crossy Road. Me and my mom played Pac-Man, and my mom was so caught, like, she was so in the zone, she was lost in the sauce, to the point that she moved the table, like the little joystick table. Here, me and my little brother played Super Mario Racing, Mario Kart, I'm stupid. Oh, he got first place.
His doesn't matter, I'll get back to you.
I went, chose Donkey Kong, you know, as one does. And I chose the hardest track and the hardest CPUs on the hardest speed difficulty. And then I lost. I got third place because the game would not drift. The game was broken. It was doo-doo. I got scammed again. I got scammed twice in this one Dave & Buster's. Come on, New York. Fix your stuff.
He's a loser!
I then saw a machine that I have never done in my life and I have always wanted to do. What is that machine, you may ask yourself? You may ask me, actually, because I'm the cool one here. It was DDR. Freaking DDR. I have never done this and I was so hyped to do it. DDR is pretty much a rhythm game, you know? You see arrows, you move your foot, you click the arrow, right? With your foot on the little pad below. Here at home, I've played rhythm games here at home, you know? When I play rhythm games, it looks like this. Here at home, I only play with my fingers, you know, 3 or 4 fingers. And I thought, oh, I'm pretty good at, you know, rhythm game at home with the fingers. So it should just transfer over to my feet because it's like the same thing. Just move your feet, right? So I, you know, I need to get ego checked. And I put my little brother on easy. I myself chose the hard difficulty. And I'm like, it should be easy. It should be just like home. I might mess up here and there, but I should do fairly well. So I was looking through the song list and I recognized a song that I knew from back home. So I'm like, I'm gonna choose it. And that song goes a little like this. This song is intense. It was a mistake. Oh gosh, here we go. I was missing left, right, forward, and back. I was missing almost everything. I would hit them occasionally. I would put my hands on the little, like, the support poles in the back to maybe help me. But no, I did not know what I was up against. This, I was at a very big disadvantage because I was also wearing these, like, really big, warm, like, winter boots. So those kind of weighed me down, and they were pretty big, so I didn't know where I was stepping. And I also never done DDR, so I don't know, like, the space of how far, like, the little buttons on the floor. I know, like, the keyboard is like boom, pow, like the little lengths I gotta move, right? But no, I was horrible. The people that were playing before me that let me on, I didn't see their reaction, but I'm pretty sure they were like laughing, like they were just like thinking to themselves, dang, this guy sucks. Oh my gosh, it was a nightmare. And there were also like the two cute Asian girls that were like getting ready to play after me, and I bet they were also laughing in horror because DDR is kind of like from like Asia or something, so this is their game and they're watching me just suffer. And I this was the most painful thing that happened. And woo, subway back home. Woo, the subway. Hey, we decided to go and see the building from above, you know. We got tickets to visit a building called the One Vanderbilt, and we would go all the way to the top. They had a bunch of, you know, mirrors and kind of attraction stuff. So here I am. They give us some sunglasses because, you know, mirrors and the sun can reflect and it hurts your eyes. And they also gave us these little cloths to put on our shoes at the bottom, like, yeah, on our shoes, so we don't like get the, like, the glass mirrors dirty, even though, you know, you're probably gonna be touching them with your hands. This right here, this is just the elevator. Hi, this is just the elevator, and it's already trippy because everything is mirrors. It's crazy. Here we are entering the first room, and boom, mirror, it's just mirrors everywhere. Mirrors above you, on the floor, to your left, to your right, forward, behind you. It's mirrors everywhere. And it looks pretty cool, I guess. It's a little trippy, but it's fine. Look at me down there. Hey! Here you can see out the window. Look at the, like, you can see all the buildings, the tall buildings. You can see over there, there's a skating rink. I can't skate, so, you know, we're not doing that. Here I am laying down with my family. A bunch of people were doing this, just laying down and looking up, because the ceiling is also mirrors, so you could just look up and see yourself. They had a bunch of different types of rooms as well. Here's the different rooms they had. They had the cum room, and then they had the building, a little room with the building that we're in. That's the building that we're in. Pretty cool, very cool. It's like it's really nice to me. Yeah, I'm up there somewhere. really nice made. It's got like a little antenna up there. You can see like the parking, some cars, or like just the surrounding area of it. We have the balls room. Personally, my favorite, because balls. Who wouldn't love balls?
What's poppin', gamers? Quick update, my mom popped the ball, so we're leaving now. Come on, how did she? I don't know how, but she did it. She popped the ball. So we're out before we get kicked out.
Here we have a little area to take pictures, so we didn't get in the line. And here we have a screen that would actually show your face on the clouds, and it's nightmare material. It looks like something in your nightmares, you know, it's very scary. We have a little cafe up here too. And then there's this sign, you know. I completely understand, because if you throw something off and you hit someone in the head, it's going to be a problem, you know, you might kill someone. And it's also littering to just throw stuff on the road, so I understand why you can't throw stuff over the building. But as long as I can continue throwing car batteries in the ocean, I'm completely fine. And here we're getting off, we're getting back in the elevator, the trippy elevator, and I'm just going to give you a little bit of a feel of what it's like, you know, to like go down, because you go down 90 floors really, really fast.
Okay, with the flashing lights and sound?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Van a poner las luces brillantes así, los sonidos también.
Drop like 90 floors in like 10 seconds out. That hurts.
And then after that, we found the Lego store. And there are so many things I record in the Lego store. It's such a cool store. I love Lego so much. I'm just gonna give a little quick montage of the stuff I saw, because it's just a lot. We then watched the Charlie Brown Christmas in live, you know. It's just like a Broadway show, because, you know, we're a Broadway, we gotta watch a Broadway show. So we went to go watch that. I couldn't record anything because, you know, they wouldn't let me. After that, we went back home with a big pizza. It was very good. It was like, you know, the good New York corner store style pizzas. It's Christmas! Woo! Merry Christmas, everybody. A little late, but it's okay. And we still have pizza left over. Nice. And today we decided to just walk Central Park. So here's some of that. Little patch of green over there. But yep, this is all Central Park. It's just a little path, dead trees, and a bunch of leaves. If there's something interesting, I'll record it. But apart from that...
Waterfall.
Or the bridge. Oh my god, is that a crocodile? Wow, there's nothing. The never ending void. Cool, that's poggers. Alright. Statue of an old dead guy and horses. Cool. The subway again! Woo! And on the final day, we had a nice breakfast. I said goodbye to our hotel one last time. We blasted off again. And while on the plane, I decided to buy this kid's meal that came with Oreos, gummies, and Cheez-Its. Because this kid's meal came with a little like air badge. Here's that badge. I really liked it. Very cool. You don't gotta look at the food. Don't worry about it. Yeah, nice patch. Nice. And we were finally back home. And on our way home, we decided that we would stop by and eat. Welcome home.